So today we have a special guest on my new show, not Coffee with Karan, it's Chat with Karan, because you know that's controversial nowadays, Coffee with Karan.
Hi, how are you?
Hi Karan, how are you doing?
Great, great, pleasure for you to be here on
pleasure
the show.
Pleasure is all mine. Hi everybody.
How do you balance, your work life and your passion? So how do you do it?
Well, great. You answered the question within the question itself. When you have something which you're passionate about, you find time for it. You don't need to, look for the time. You make time for it. And luckily for me, the weekends are that time for me where I get to spend time with my passion, which is photography. I would say storytelling is my passion, and photography is a way I tell my stories very effectively, or at least I think. I do theater and I do filmmaking as well. But photography is very close to my heart. So yeah, weekends are the time when I spend on it. And this area of fine art photography, I used to, back in college days, I used to paint as well. Right. And I've been heavily influenced by painters from different era, especially the Renaissance era. And as the time goes by, personally, my patience to sit in front of the easel, it waned away. And camera happened to be a good tool to create paintings. So I sort of started to experiment with my camera to make pictures which looked like paintings. I initially thought I was the only one who was doing that. But of course, with the internet coming in, we got to know that there are quite a lot of photographers in the world who have taken up to fine art photography. So my long-standing love affair with paintings and new acquired skill with photography actually merged together, and I started experimenting more into the fine art area of photography.
Right. So you've been traveling a lot. Your job, I think, is hectic in terms of travel. And now the situation is such that you are mostly at home, you work from home. So
that is correct.
How do you balance both the things now?
So, and this is a very interesting point, actually. Yes, my job took me to places. So I've visited Europe, I visited US, lots of parts of Asia. So I've been around everywhere, and I felt that when I was growing as a photographer, the need for external stimulus is quite high. You need to see good places, you need to meet different kind of people, you need to interact with different stimulus from outside to trigger different thoughts within you. But when you reach a particular stage when you sort of know where you're going, you know what your art is, then the need to actually see a lot of places in the world does not remain as critical as it used to be before. So I mean, these days I've been homebound for last 5 months, or more than that actually. My last travel was in the month of January. I visited Japan. In fact, within 2 weeks, I visited England and Japan because of my work travel. Now I'm restarting to do my photo shoots. And I found there are, small little corners in Singapore. Right. If you bring your creative artistry to the table, you actually do have enough to go around to create the kind of work which you're looking for. So yes, I would love to do travel again as it opens. But without travel, I think within the places where we have, there's still quite a lot to go through, and one can create good pieces of art within the realm that we're currently living in. A little bit of a help. So I was very lucky to join some workshops of some of the other renowned photographers. One of them, quite a few of them are still my very good friends. So I joined their workshops. in those workshops, I mean, a lot of people say, hey, did you come back with good pictures? Of course, I came back with good pictures, but that's not what you go to the workshop for. You go to the workshop to basically look at things differently. You go there and see, okay, this is a professional photographer. He's at a mountain or some you know, fort. The way he or she is seeing that particular monument is very different from the way you see it. So it's basically getting those insights which help me to say, okay, my kind of photography is about creating stories, and that's how I want to look at world, that's how I look at light, that's how I look at subjects. So that helped me quite a bit. So I sort of started creating the kind of fine art work which is available on my Instagram, which is sand.cocktails, as you shared.
Oh, nice. That's good. And if you tell me about the website, the photographs that are there, are they for commercial also? Are you selling it or promoting it online? Like if someone wants to buy, so what is the process?
Yes, they are available. So I'm currently only able to sell the digital version of those photographs. So if anybody is interested in buying, they can drop me a message and we can discuss on what kind of format are they looking at. So we can definitely do that. But more of my work is customized, produced for somebody's requirement. So either people who are looking to create a big printout or a frame print of their portraits or their family pictures or some other artistic pictures. So I do that for the clients on demand. So that's majority of what my work is. Then I do some work for editorials and some fashion houses and those kind of magazines as well. But it's all about in that genre of creating artistic images, whether it is for your own personal consumption or for commercial or for editorial use. It's about that genre. I like to shoot people. I mean, people photography is my area, but shooting people in more fine art genre rather than just plain simple beauty portraits kind of thing.
Any projects in India, or are you planning to have any projects in India?
India is an amazing place. Right now the situation of travel is a little bit of a challenge. But with India, I had a project in mind where we were looking to go to a few states, which are amazing places, amazing culture. I was looking to conduct some workshops in different states, and actually use the local talent and capture the beauty of those places and create some artistic pictures out of that. I'm sure. There's a lot of interest from foreigners, and there is a lot of interest from Indians as well to do something together. So I definitely will be embarking on that pretty quickly. Not of course as soon as the travel opens, but as soon as situations stabilize a little bit, we'll be looking to go to places like Ladakh, like Darjeeling, like Varanasi for that matter, places in south which are in the jungle area, so near to Uti kind of segment, or even the backwaters, which is in Calicut and stuff like that. So each space has its own charm, it has its own romanticism. So my idea is to create a garland of a story, visiting different places in India, and mixing the people and the environment that those places offer in a fine art photograph.
Yeah, I saw quite a few coverages about your work. I saw a picture in Vogue also.
One of them appeared on the online platform of Photo Vogue. Yes, and I've got a few publications in European magazines called Dark Beauty and Simply Portrait. Some of my work has been published in different areas. Recently, I got one of my set of images, which are mix of fashion and artistic images got published in an online magazine. Right. As these days, majority of the magazines are going online, so just the nature of the beast as it is.
Yeah. And I believe you are taking workshops also in Singapore, and you are teaching fellow people who are interested.
Correct. So I do conduct workshops. The only thing different in terms of what I do in my workshop is not to tell them or teach them my style. My workshop is about helping people to find their style and helping them find their voice in photography. I mean, of course, if somebody is interested in learning my style, that is also available. But typically, my workshops are about creating some sort of a scene or some sort of a theme, and then letting different styles of photographer experiment with their own, you know, thought process with that. So we conducted one a few months ago. I think it's almost 8 or 9 months ago. We conducted one on the basics of finance photography. We'll be doing a few more workshops as the situation eases out in Singapore as well.